Good morning, students. Yesterday we discussed about polynomial. Okay. Today we discussed how we represent the polynomial in using array, one-dimensional array, and two-dimensional array. So here this is my polynomial. So polynomial can be represented using array or linked list. So in exam point of view, they may ask the representation of polynomial using array or linked list. Linked list already explained how we represent the linked list. So in linked list, what we have to do is just first one is coefficient is stored and the exponential is stored. Then next contains the address of the next one. Okay, clear. So by using array, see here it is. So in array, these are the indexes here. 0, 1, 2, 3 is the index. And we can represent here from first one, that is 9. Okay, so 9 is means here, x coefficient is 0 here, so x power 0, so I locate the 0 at 9. Okay, here x power is 1, x power 1 is not there, so I represent 0 here. Okay, so here indexes is nothing but the power of x, and here these are the coefficients. Okay, clear, students? Okay, these are the x power 0, x power 1, x power 2, x cube. These are the power of x, and the this one is the coefficient value. Okay. So here array can be represented in two ways. In polynomial can be represented in two ways. So this is representation one, and another one is representation two. See here representation one. I already told you here p dash x. Okay, so here I write the powers up to 3. So 0 to 3 I write here, and in 0, 6 is there, in 1, 2 is there, in 2, 3 is there, and so on. This is the way of representation. Similarly, we can represent here p2 is here, same way. You can represent the second equation. Here x power 4 is there. So what we have to take here is here power is 4, so I take here power 4 value. Okay. So index 0 to 4 I have considered here. So in the next one, see here. See this equation. Say here this is power is 21. So I create 21 indexes here. Here 21, and I locate the values where it belongs. So see here 0th location 6, and second location 2, and fifth 3. Okay. So minus 3 is 1, so on. There are no elements. I represent with the null, and at 21 it is 16. Okay. So for this type of representation one here, how we representation one? First you have to see the power of x, and you have to take the array size from there, and you have to store the particular coefficient value in that power value of x. Okay. So what are the advantages here? See here, what are the advantages have? Only good for non-spare polynomials. Okay. So it is good for non-spare polynomials. So in this type of polynomials, it is good. And easy of storage and retrieval. So it is easy to store and retrieval. So disadvantage means how to allocate arrays as ahead of times. So a disadvantage is to allocate a size at ahead of times. Okay, and and hook array size is required for spare polynomials here. This is the spare polynomials here. Power 21. Remaining elements are not there. Not there. So this must have memory is waste. So this is we call it as a sparse polynomials and waste of space. So this is waste of space. Okay. Then you can represent in another way. That is polynomial two representation. See here. Here we will store in representation. We will store the power x exists. That value is only we can store here. We do not store the unknown power. So see here, x power 5, x power 6, I allocate memory. X power 7, I allocate memory. So this is of waste of memory. So in representation two, what I can do is what are the value in the expression? That value I can allocate to the array. Okay. So see here. At power 9 exponent 8 power 7 18 power 6 man just to represent the end. So here this is the exponential, this is a coefficient which starts from left to right. Location starts from left to right and see here. Okay, so this type representation advantage already know memory save space. Okay. Disadvantages of representation is so it is difficult to maintain. Okay, so if you consider the here difficult to maintain means you have to see the exponential and you have to store and it is difficult to maintain to store the values. So but you allocate space, but it is difficult to maintain. And for addition subtraction here this type representation requires more code. Okay, so for subtraction and addition of this type of representation it requires more code for executing the program or executing the expression. Okay, so this is about polynomials. And today next we go to the last topic. First we see the syllabus, then what we have to do is just to wait here students. See students, so already covered pointers and point using array and linked list, how to represent the node by using structure. I discussed single linked list and traversing, searching, all are explained in single linked list. Insertion, deletion operations also explained in single linked list. Header list I already explained. Header contains the info and the data. Next node header is the first node. Header act as an engine in the in train. How the engine perform. So in the same way we are able here we start every linked list we have to start with header node only. Okay, next circular linked list I explained. Double linked list already explained. Linked stack, linked queue. Okay, I will explain here now. And polynomial we already discussed it there. Then today we discussed sparse matrix and linked stack and linked queue. Okay. Okay, clear students. So first we discussed about the sparse matrix. then we move to the So see here, what is sparse matrix? So here a sparse matrix is a matrix having relatively small number of non-zero element. So here we have a matrix is there, and that matrix contains very few number of non-zero elements. We call it as a sparse matrix. See here, non-zero elements are 2, 3, 1. Zero elements are 6. Non-zero elements are 2. So this we call it as a sparse matrix. So the another definition is a sparse matrix is a matrix in which number of zero elements are more than the number of non-zero elements. Okay. So number of zero elements are more than the number of non-zero elements, then we call it as a sparse matrix. Okay, clear students, are any doubts? So number of a sparse matrix contains the more number of zero elements, we call it as a matrix contains more number of zero elements, we call it as a sparse matrix. Can I move forward? So now the sparse matrix representation using triplet here. Okay, so in this triplet, what we have to do is see here, what is triplet means here. In this way, how to represent the sparse matrix. So here we consider only non-zero values along with their row and column. Okay. So here we have to consider only non-zero values along with their row and column. So here how many rows are there? Total here how we in this representation, what we have to do? Zeroth row stores total rows, and zeroth total columns and total non-zero values in the matrix. Okay, this is my zeroth row. So zeroth row stores the total rows, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 total rows, 5. Total columns are 6, and total non-zero values are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so in this representation, the zeroth row stores total row value, total number of rows, total number of columns, total number of non-zero values. Okay, then we have to consider one by one. So then see here, for example, zeroth row. So in zeroth row, is there any value is there? See here. Students, listen carefully. So this is my zeroth row. Here, this is my fourth column. So zeroth row, fourth column, there is a value. So zeroth row, fourth column, there is a value called 9. Okay. In this first column, first row, second column. First row, first column. So here he considered, he take it as a zeroth column, zeroth row. Okay. Here he considered as zeroth column. That's why he write here. So zeroth column and fourth position, we store the value is 9. And here for first row, first column, the element is 8. And here if there are same column, same row, two elements are there. So one by one you have to represent here. So here, second row, zeroth column, we have 4, and second row, third column. See here, second row, third column. Here there is a mistake here. Second row, third column, there is the value is 2. Okay. Next, see here. Third row, fifth column, 5. Okay. Fourth row, second column, 2. So we represent the sparse matrix in triplet form. Just remember here, we have to store only the non-zero elements in triplet form. Triplet table, you have to store only non-zero elements. Okay, clear students? So here I let us give another example, sparse matrix. This is also sparse matrix. So sparse matrix can be represented using triples. Triples are nothing but row, total number of row, total number of column, total number of values. See here, in this total number of rows is 3, total number of column is 3. See, total number of rows is 3, total number of column is 3. And total number of non-zero element, non-zero values is 3. Okay. So first, see here in this way, you have to represent here where it is 0th row, 0th column. So 0th row, 0th column 2, 0th row, first column 3, and there are no, so here second row, first column 5. Okay, clear students, are any doubt? So next we move to the transpose of the matrix, transpose of sparse matrix. So here to transpose of a sparse matrix, just we have to interchange rows and columns only. Okay. Just to see how we see the slide here. Okay, then transpose of a sparse matrix. So see here, transpose format, what I told you that just we have to try change the rows into column. So this is a sparse matrix because number of non-zero values are less and the number of zero values are more. So this is a sparse matrix. So this can change this row, this column into row. So here 00 is transpose, 0800 transpose, 002 transpose, 020 transpose. So I just interchange the rows and columns. Okay. So then how we transpose the sparse matrix when it is in triplet form. So this is our triplet form. Okay. In this form, so triplet means what we have to do. Triplet is nothing but it contains number of rows, number of columns, and number of total values. Okay. So this is 5 rows, 5 columns, and 6 non-zero elements. So here when we have to change the triplet, understand, we represent the sparse matrix in triplet form. So if you in exam there, if we gave the triplet form, then how you transpose. So see example, this is the example given here. So total number of rows is 5, total number of rows is 6, columns is 6, and total number of non-zero values is 6. This is the matrix given. Okay. So if we give in this pattern, then just you have to change this row and column. Okay, just you have to change this row and column. Okay, so here 5 changes here and 6 comes here, 0 here, 4 here, 1 1 0 2, just interchange these two only. Okay student, interchange these two only. So after interchange you have to sort it. How you start it means, then you have to consider the zeroth row. So in this here, zeroth row is one only here, one element is there, and zeroth row second column value is 4. So when we have to sorted, we cannot change 6 by 6 value. When just in one, in first you have to only interchange these two, then you have to perform sort. In sorting order, you cannot change this zeroth column. Sorry, zeroth row. You can sort the remaining elements. You don't change the zeroth row. Okay, clear. So just see here. In first consider the zeroth row. So zeroth row is this one, and next consider the column. So zeroth row second column is 4. Zeroth row second column is 4. If there is any other element in zeroth row, then you have to place here. Okay. So there are no element. Only one element is there. Just I kept here. Next you can move to the first row. First row, first column 8, and next you have to consider second. Second row fourth column 2, then third. Third row second column 2, fourth. Fourth row zeroth column 9, and last one is fifth. Fifth row third column is 5. Okay, in this way you have to represent the you have to find the you have to transpose the triplet form. If you given exam point of view want to transfer that, you can do like this. Okay, so see another example also. See here, this is the so this is the triplet he given here. So 6 6 8. So just first you have to interchange the rows so and column, then after that just you have to interchange the columns. So see here 0 0 1 5 2 0 0 1 5, and 0 3 2 2 3 0. Okay, just interchange these two. Next 0 3 2 3 0, 5 0 to 0 5 to 5 0. Okay, after interchange you just store the positions. Okay, then after interchange then you get here in zeroth row zeroth column 15, zeroth row zeroth column 15, and zeroth row and fourth column we have 91. Okay, if duplicate is there, just you first preference to the next preference to column order. So here we have in second row two values are there. One is first column and next one is fifth column. So first you have to consider the first column, then you have to consider the fifth column. Okay, so in this way you have to represent the you have to transfer the when the matrix in triplet form, you have to first interchange the row and column, then you have to sort the triplet. Okay, clear. Next, how we represent the sparse matrix using linked list. So how we represent the sparse matrix using linked list. See here, here each node has 4 fields. Okay, first one is row, second one is column, and third one is value. Okay, we already know in triplet form how we represent. The same we represent here. So index of row where non-zero element is located, and here also in linked list representation we can represent only the non-zero elements only. We can store in linked list. We cannot store the zero element. We can store only non-zero elements. So here each node has 4 fields. One is zero row and column, then value. Next one is next node address. Okay. So here row, index of row where non-zero element is located, and column, index of column where non-zero element is located, and value of non-zero element located at index row and column, and next node indicates the address of the next node. See here, first we have consider zeroth row. Okay, there is zeroth row, second column, value is 3. Next, zeroth row, fourth column, value is 4. Okay, next we just store the only non-zero elements here. Remember that you have to store only non-zero element. Next, what you have to do? Next, you take one. So first row, second column, fifth, and first row, third column, seven, and next you move to the third row, first column, values two, and third row, second. Last is represented with null because the list is end here. Okay, clear students? Sir, any doubt? Okay, clear. So this is the one more topic is there. That is how we represent the linked list using stack. Okay, students, just see. So I forgot to explain this topic, just see here. Okay, so it is visible, students. So just you know that what is linked stack and linked queue. See here. So what is linked stack and linked queue? So linked stack is a linear list of elements commonly implemented in single linked list whose start pointer performs the role of the top pointer of the stack. Okay. Here, what we have to stack here, start pointer is nothing but in linked list. In linked list, what we have to do, single linked list, what we have to do is, we have to store the address of the first node in the header or start or first. So whose start pointer performs the role of the point top? So what is the top in the stack? Top is nothing but the portion of the stack. So here, start pointer act as a top. Okay. And linked key is also a linear list of elements commonly implemented as a single linked list, but with two pointers, that is front and rear. Okay. So we already know queue, we already know the stack. So see here. I am representing a stack in this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, queue in this way. Okay, so this is front end and this is rear end. You already know this is top of the stack. Okay, so in linked list you can represent it this way. You can represent it in this way, linked list. You already know in English contains node. So node contains two field. First one is info, second one is link. This is stacks here in this top. This is friend, this is rare. Okay. So here, what is the property of the stack is there? What is the property here? That is last in, first out. What is queue property? First in, first out. So if you want to insert the element, so you can insert in from just how we insert in linked list in the same way. You can insert, but if you want to delete, you delete at rare and none because last in, first out. Okay. So delete, insert from, delete rare. That is stack. Okay, clear students? Insert rare, delete rare. Okay, insert rare, delete rare. Okay, then this is the property. See here, you will move to the next slide. See here, same just operation you have to perform here. See here, if you want to get a node, okay, get the node I want to insert here, just you can insert there. Just as the rules we see there, that are the same rule we follow here. So if you want to delete the node, just store the first node address in some temporary variable, and then you delete that node, then you have to return that value. I already told in single linked list the same concept from here. Okay, but you have to perform there only how you insert is there, and how you insert and how you delete, you have to choose there only. Okay. Okay, just see, we want to insert the element. So for example, I just store here. First I insert B, next C, next G, next H. So how we insert this? So insert here rare in linked list. Insert rare, then delete where, delete also rare. Or insert friend, delete friend. You can insert friend or delete friend. Okay, clear students? So if you want to perform stack using linked list, just insert rare, insert friend. Just using insert rare, delete rare, or insert friend, delete friend. That is stack. When we want to perform queue, so in queue, see here, how you can store the queue? Are you got my point, student? So here queue, insert front, okay, insert rare and delete here, okay. So just insert rare, delete friend or insert friend, delete rare. Here alternate. Okay, just see if you want to stack, insert rare, delete rare, or insert friend, delete friend, insert rare, insert friend, delete rare. So, you perform means you are using, you can perform. Okay. So I already told you the polynomial representation using linked list. Last one null means list is there. Okay. So any topic missed? We represent discrete pointers and pointer using array also discussed. Linked list, header node, double node. Okay. So third unit is completed, and next we move to the next fourth unit, that is tree. Very interesting and easy unit. No need to write any program or anything. Just you have to practice the example. It is very easy to understand the tree concept. Very easy. Okay. So just see. Just we move to the next unit, that is tree. Fourth unit, tree. That is trees. Okay. So what is tree means? So we have already told that. So I already told the data structures is classified into two types, that is linear data structure and non-linear data structure. So in linear data structure, the data will be stored in linear order, but in non-linear data structure, the data will be stored in non-linear order. So in linear data structure, we use the data structures called stack, queue, linked list. But non-linear data structure, we use trees and graphs. So here the data will not be stored in linear order. The data will be stored in non-linear order. That is in tree order represent in tree. So we have a tree is there. So tree has root is there, and there is a branches are there for tree, and leaves are there. Okay, just see what are the root and what is the leaves and what are the branches. So the same concept we use here, the word root only and the word leaves only. We call a branches as internal nodes and leaves as external nodes. Okay, so see here root and see here nodes, we call it as internal nodes and external nodes, and leaves branches. Okay, clear? So what is a tree? So a tree is a finite non-empty set of elements. So a tree is a finite non-empty set of elements. Not empty set, it is a finite set of tree is a finite non-empty set of elements. Okay, clear, students? A tree is a set of finite. A tree is a set of finite set of one or more nodes that shows parent-child relation. Okay, so a tree is a set of finite set of one or more nodes that shows the parent-child relation. Okay, see here this diagram. So this is computer. So here. Childs are sales, manufacturing, R&D, and these are the parents. This is the root node. Okay, these are the parents. These for computers, these are the childs. For US and England, these are the parents. So in this way, how to represent the tree? So tree is an abstract model of a hierarchical structure. So this structure is called as a hierarchical structure, and it consisting of a nodes with a parent-child relation. So this is the parent, this is child. So a tree consisting of a nodes. This is one node. This is another node with a parent-child relation. With a parent-child relation. So what are the applications of tree? So when we are organizing chats, we use the trees. And for storing file system, we are using trees. And for some programming environments also, we are using trees. So this is the actual diagram of the tree, but we represented this in circles. Okay, so this is the tree. So what is tree? A tree is a finite set of non-empty, finite non-empty set of elements. So tree is a finite non-empty set of elements. Okay, what is root? Root is nothing but the starting node of the tree. So here the starting node of the tree is A. So only in tree there is only one root is there, that is starting point. So node without a parent A. So A has no other connections. So A is our root node. So next, coming to the siblings. What is sibling? So sibling is nothing but two or more nodes having the same parent. So two or more nodes having the same parent, we call it as a sibling. So here BCD has the same parent A. Okay. So here B, C, D are siblings because they have the same parent A. So these are just like your own brother and sisters connection. That is your parent, then you have your child. So this is the parent, these are the child. So B, C, D are siblings of A because they have the same parent. And C, here F are the siblings of B. And GH are the siblings of C, and IJK are the sibling of X. IJK are siblings because they have the same parent F. Okay, clear students? And tomorrow we will discuss what is internal node, what is external node, what is ancestors, what is depth, what is height. All these we discussed tomorrow. Okay, and today we end the session. So anybody has any queries? Ping me a message in chat box. Very interesting unit. So all of you, please listen carefully. Very easiest unit. Okay. Tomorrow we will discuss the tree. Okay. Okay. And the session. Thank you.